smells so good.
I have a lurker.
You want to go to Vietnam?
Yeah.
This is a problem.
10 out of 10.
Whoa, no, it's leaking.
Oh, it's so good.
This is unbelievable.
Navajo fry bread. Forbidden cloud.
Mm-hmm. This is delicious.
Hi, I'm Hannah. I'm the world's okayest mom. And a while back, I asked my Instagram followers to send me their favorite recipes from all over the world so that I could cook and serve them to my family. And we had such a blast. I got so many recipes and a lot of requests for a part two. So here it is. I can't wait to see what countries we're going to visit culinarily in my kitchen. Wish me luck.
What are you doing?
Yeah. I have vivid memories of kids being teased at the lunch table for the food that they brought to school, and that will not be my kids doing the teasing. I want to expose them to these foods, so what better way to get started than to cook it ourselves? Now, I'm not an expert at any of these cuisines, so I had the wonderful help of my Instagram followers sourcing recipes for me that are super authentic to each area. Now, some of these are family recipes that I can't share, but I'll link what I have in the description, and find final warning, go get a snack. This video is going to make you hungry.
Hi Hannah, it's Crystal. I would love for your family to try my recipe for pitka. It's sweet, it's savory, it's rich, and it goes perfectly over white rice. I hope you guys enjoy.
Hi.
Oh, what are you making?
Can you say this with me? Pitka.
Pitka.
It's Whoa. A Vietnamese dish with rice.
Vietnamese.
Yep. I have green onions, I have garlic, fish sauce.
Hi.
All right, I got my marinade ready.
While the meat was marinating, I made the dry caramel.
I'm gonna put 2 tablespoons of sugar in a dry pot.
You have to watch it very carefully because it can burn really quickly. My kitchen smelled incredible at this point.
Good.
Excellent.
I think it looked gorgeous on the plate. It was this golden, golden meat. I couldn't wait to try this. And I couldn't wait to see what the kids thought.
What do you think, Jackson?
It was worth the wait.
The boys were in love.
It's so good.
Is it?
You look thrilled.
There were so many comments last time saying Wyatt looked pissed when he said he liked stuff. What his body language and expression is saying isn't always what he means.
Resting Wyatt face.
I'm very ready to try this.
Yay! I'm so proud of that.
Worth it. What do you think?
It's delicious.
Oh, it's delicious this time.
Yeah, it melts in your mouth.
He has words today.
I sent a photo of the dish to my follower, and she said that she would feed it to her Vietnamese in-laws.
I want to go to Vietnam.
You should.
You want to go to Vietnam?
Yeah.
Eat all the food.
Eat all the food. Should I make this again?
Yes.
We love it.
Hi, Hannah. This is Jennifer, and I would love for you and your family to try some traditional Haitian recipes for griot, pickles, and bunun, or what you would call fried plantains.
Time to make some Haitian cuisine.
Griot is a citrus marinated pork that's then either baked or fried. I prepped the pork the day before. I diced it, and then I marinated it in all of this lovely citrus.
And now I'm prepping my pickles. There wasn't the tricolor cabbage, so I'm just using the plain cabbage. And so I'm gonna cover this. I'm gonna let it marinate for about 2 hours.
All right, I'm cooking this pork for about 30 minutes.
I feel like after the last week of Food Around the World, I got a lot more comfortable with frying. So I felt very ready to fry these plantains.
I don't know if I'm supposed to stand them up like this.
Oh, my house was smelling amazing. Combined with the pork marinated in all this citrus, it was just a lot of good smells going in my house.
I'm gonna test smashing one of the plantains, and I'm gonna try some foil and a pan. Oh, there we go. I think that worked. Now I'm gonna dip it in my water, salt, and vinegar, and then I'm gonna refry it. I have a lurker.
It smells good.
Smells good. Looks good.
Looks good. Smells good. It is good. Thank you.
Well, we'll see if I do a good job.
I can't wait.
I thought this plate looked magnificent.
That's more bananas.
Basically.
How are you doing that?
With your fingers.
Now the boys were a little confused when I served them and we didn't have any silverware. And that's why it was so important for me to serve it the way that it's usually eaten, so that when they see someone eating with their hands, they can think to themselves, oh, I've eaten with my hands, and I know that certain foods are meant to be eaten with your hands.
Mmm. Mmm.
Oh my gosh.
I was surprised especially about the pickles because the flavor is pretty sharp and the kids loved them and they were just piling them onto their pork and asking for more.
What do we rate this?
10 out of 10.
10 out of
10. 10 out of 10.
You know, when my kids are excited about food, that comes out as total silliness. So it was a really silly and fun night. Everyone was in a good mood because everyone was eating good food.
You want more pickles?
Pickles.
I'm making something tonight that I think the kids are gonna freak out over and I'm very excited to make. I'm making Navajo fry bread tonight, which is basically, oh my God. I dropped my flour.
Now, fry bread is a dish that's served in many indigenous cultures, not just Navajo. So there are many different variations and lots of different recipes.
The recipe that I was given had two different ways to serve it. One was like kind of a taco and one was a little more sweet with a berry jam on top. So I'm gonna do the sweet one. I did order one thing special because my follower said that it has to be bluebird flour.
This flour comes in a sack.
So we're just gonna drizzle it with a little oil. And cover it for 2 hours.
It smells so good. I wanna just take a bite. What is this? Forbidden cloud. Now the sauce I'm gonna make for this fry bread is called wajapi. It's just berries and water. And get this really thin. Are you in here snooping?
Yeah.
I think it's a little too thin. I'm gonna do the next one a little thicker. That's looking beautiful. I think I finally got the hang of this.
When it was done, it looked like this beautiful puffy bread loaf with that gorgeous berry sauce on top. The boys were in heaven eating this.
Who gave this the right to be this delicious? Look at how fluffy it is inside.
That's really good.
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10. 11 out of 10. We'll be making this again.
Hey, Hannah, it's your friend Jasmine. I'd love for you and your family to try my recipes for Korean tofu, cucumber salad, and braised potatoes. They're some of my favorite Korean side dishes called panchans. They are packed with flavor, very garlicky, so good luck on the breath. But they're worth it, I swear. Hope you like it.
Hello again. It's me prepping my Korean food.
Of course, I'm gonna make something that Jasmine suggests. She makes the most delicious, beautiful food.
I'm going to prep the tofu and the cucumbers tonight. I got my cucumbers drying over here. I sprinkled them with salt. I'm gonna chop my green onion and get the rest of my marinade together.
Hi.
We have our tofu marinade.
I pan fried the tofu first to get it nice and crispy, and then I reduced my marinade a little bit in a pan, added the tofu back in, and then put that all in a container to chill in the fridge overnight.
And let's move on to our cucumber marinade. Okay, we gotta let these marinate overnight. You know, he's here, are you supposed to help me? He's been sitting on this stool the whole time.
Matt has it pretty easy when it comes to food in this house, but just you wait, he will get his.
To finish out our Korean meal, I have my potato peeler so kindly peeling potatoes for me. So this Korean potato recipe is very simple.
It was just soy sauce and honey and garlic. I added a little bit more honey and sesame seeds after. When I put everything together on the plate, it looked like my dream meal.
It's like all the little bites.
Mmm,
I love it. Yummy.
I even bought the spoons that I saw Jasmine using.
These potatoes are incredible.
Moment of truth, Matt, try the tofu. My family.
I already went through one piece.
Oh, you did? Did you like it?
Mm-hmm.
My family always gives me grief when I make tofu.
They really liked it. Everybody loved this food.
I don't think we'll have any leftovers. We are one happy family today.
Hi, Hannah. I'm Grace.
And I'm Devante.
And we want to share a recipe for Bohemian Guava Duff with you.
What you'll find is that this dessert recipe is something that's used in many different Bohemian households. Enjoy.
Here are my guava preserves. A dollar. A deal.
A guava duff is a sweet, fruit-filled cake-ish roll that's boiled instead of baked. So I cut in a bunch of shortening and then I had some baking powder and salt.
So I'm nervous about this. I don't know how thin I'm supposed to roll this dough out. I also had to roll it out with a bottle of wine because they don't have a rolling pin. I'm gonna do a good amount. Oh, jeez, okay. Did I do this right?
When I went to roll it up, I think I had rolled the dough a little too thick. So all of my guava was spilling out and and just getting smushed by the heaviness of this loaf.
Now I'm supposed to seal the ends. Oh gosh, I have just a handful of jam.
Got this all wrapped up in its blanket.
So the boiling aspect of this duff, I think, keeps it really, really, I don't want to say this word, M-O-I-S-T, and makes it more of like a puddingy cake instead of a dry cake. It was really the moment of truth when I unrolled it to see if all of my guava had spilled out. So when I unrolled it, it looked pretty good. I was shocked.
I really hope I get that spiral in the middle.
Ooh, well, no, it's leaking. Why did I do this? Oh,
okay.
The spiral needed a little work.
I have some rum cream sauce on here.
What's that?
Ooh, it's dessert.
I gave it to the boys and their minds were blown.
That tastes like apple pie.
Do you like it?
Mm-hmm. No.
Love it. It's like a fluffier apple pie though, right? 10 out of 10? Wow. It's like if pie crust and cinnamon rolls had a baby. I've never had a pastry like this. This is delicious. We're going to Peru tonight for dinner.
We made green arroz con pollo. It is a chicken and rice dish that's all kind of cooked in one pot with this amazing green sauce.
It smells so good.
I started out by browning the chicken.
That chicken looks nice. In the chicken drippings, I'm going to toast the rice.
I added the green sauce and stock to my rice.
Oh my gosh. Okay, that heat's too hot. Okay, that was very intense.
I laid the chicken on top and then you just let it cook. When I finally pulled it out, it was beautifully green. The chicken looked super juicy and the rice looked really fluffy and delicious. Everybody loved this dish. Even Henry loved this dish. Henry actually got to eat this for dinner.
You like it?
Yeah.
This is probably my favorite, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
It's always a good day when everyone enjoys the food. This dish was really easy. I could see it becoming a staple recipe in our house.
Wow. It's so flavorful. Thumbs up.
Oh, yeah.
We're making mofongo tonight.
Mofongo is a dish made of plantains and crispy pork skins, which are also called chicharrones. And it's typically served with a stew, or it can be stuffed with meat or stuffed with food, but it's all compacted into a little mound. I'm back with the plantains. I did fry them and I really feel like that's my calling now. Jackson now thinks he's a vlogger, so he kind of took over the filming for this one.
So I'm like over there in her room. So that means I can secretly dance.
Watch out, I have a sharp knife. So I'm gonna mash the plantains with these pork skins, crispy pork skins, and some garlic.
I packed it all in a bowl and then went to flip it to take it out, and that's where I met a roadblock.
Oh no. I'm stuck. Oh, there we go.
It looked incredible. It smelled amazing. I plated it with a beef stew because it looked hearty and it looked like it would go along with it, and I could not wait to see the boys' reactions.
So good.
They loved it. I think Jackson probably loved it most of all. He was slurping it up. Wyatt wouldn't use a fork or anything to get the mofongo off the dome. Wyatt is just, he is who he is and we love him for it, and that's it.
Oh my gosh, I could demolish this whole thing in 2 seconds. This is delicious.
Oh,
10 out of 10?
10 out of 10.
What do you think, honey?
Yeah.
You want more?
I will definitely be making this again. It's really easy to find ingredients. It's easy to make, and the kids really enjoyed it.
Puerto Rico knows what they're doing.
I feel like we hit the jackpot. These dishes now go in my Rolodex of recipes that I want to make forever. And I want to keep doing this because I think it's a really important learning experience for teaching them about appreciating other cultures and appreciating other foods and smells and textures and ways of eating. So I just want to also thank all of you for sending me your recipes. I wish I could document them all, but I'm certainly making them all. And my kids and I are so appreciative and grateful to have these special dishes in our house.
So that's all for now. I'm Hannah, and tell me what country's food we should try next. Please link me some recipes, and please let me know if you'd like to see a part 3 of this. And if you'll please excuse me, Henry and I have some cuddles to do. Did you like the food?
Till next time.